This is my lonely little station. I am an engine company of one. I live so far out in the middle of nowhere, there's no one else to respond from the station except for me.
My brand new Wildland engine
is behind that door. I've also got
a surplus military water tank, a tanker,
so I can fill up. We don't have any hydrants, we don't have any water around here apart from just drafting from ponds, and I don't know where this came from. Obviously, Uncle Sam, maybe they donated it. I don't know how many gallons exactly that is. I would say somewhere between 2,000 and 3,000, probably closer to 3,000, that's a guess. But that is my water supply, so you probably want to go and take a peek inside.
Oh, you're going to like this, guys. You're really going to like this. This is quite a machine.
That's the front axle. Do you know what that means? Four-wheel drive. Four-wheel drive. That's an upgrade. Look at these tires. This is a proper Wildland engine. Burly diesel, automatic Allison transmission, 750-gallon tank. Oh, I love it. Just got everything transferred over. From the other one, what happened to my other engine? It broke down. Well, it didn't necessarily break down, but I cracked the water tank on it. It's from like 1986, I believe, and I don't know if it's gonna be repaired, but it doesn't look like it. So in the meantime, I get this one. Not a new engine, but it is very cool. There's a full pump panel. It's an old airport crash truck. An airport crash truck. And another cool feature it's got, a turret or monitor. I can go crazy, I can spray water from the inside without even getting out of the cab. Really cool the way it's set up here. So this right here is the 3-inch line that goes up. I can open the valve here and then I can control that monitor up there from right here. I can engage the pump, I can do all of everything that I need to do, open the tank section and fill and recert in here without going outside. Yeah, pretty cool. Here's the battery switch, PTO to engage the pump, floodlights, all the lights for the turret. I've even got all the water tank level indicators in here to tell me how much water I have in the tank. That's pretty cool. Four-wheel drive engage. Low range over here. This is a capable truck. This thing will go about anywhere. It's almost like a tank. So I haven't got to use it on a fire yet. I just brought it up here, got it equipped and rigged up. But that's pretty nice, huh? I'm holding you down low. I don't want you to see the name of our fire department. Sorry. There's a pump panel. Yeah, this is a really nice truck. Four-wheel drive. That is something else. Yeah. There we go. GMC. Jimmy Diesel. There's that monitor up there. That's what I can control there and spray water from the cab. That'll be really useful on wildland fires. Really useful. So I wanted to share that with you, the new brush. So this is, I think this meets the criteria for a Type 4. We can find out here. Pull out our handy dandy Wildland Fire IRPG. The IRPG is the Incident Response Pocket Guide, and it's something, it is the Bible for wildland firefighters. And if you know the contents of this book, you'll be one squared away firefighter, because it is an incredible book. The way it's laid out, the ease of use, the reference material in here is wonderfully done. The federal government doesn't always get it right, but they sure do get it right with this thing. Invaluable. How to deal with helicopters, air ops, fuel loads, fuel temperatures, how to take weather. It's just everything. Pumps, pump pressures, friction losses, everything you need to know is in here. I reference it all the time. Wildland firefighters carry these in your cargo pockets on the side. Always want to have that. But in here, we can see, we can go to the engine classification types.
So this engine, we know it's got a 750 gallon tank, right? And it's got to have a, well, it's kind of blurry. I think that diamond plate stuff's messing it all up. Let's try this. So we've got a 750 gallon tank, a 50 gallon per minute. We exceed that. We exceed that. So we are solidly, I've got more than that. So we are solidly pump and roll. I have that capability. Person two crew. So we are type four. This is a type four Wildland engine. It meets all those criterias. So I'm excited to get it on a fire. Man, this thing is the business. So I've kind of set things up the way I like it. It's not a conventional engine, but right here, this right next to the pump panel, I've got all my fittings and appliances that I like. I've got to do not only structural stuff, urban interface, but Wildland in this. So the engine's got to have a lot of stuff on it. There's the hose reel. 1-inch hose reel. I would prefer actually not to have that in there because it takes up such valuable space, but that's the way it is. It's not so bad. This compartment here, I'm still on the driver's side. What do I have in here? I've got cribbing, fill hose, cribbing for car wrecks, and blankets and water and flagging material. So here in the back, main compartment, I've got most of my all my goodies. What we got in here? Got a generator, hose clamp, positive pressure fan, extension cords, helmet sawzall, my bunker gear. We've got mixed and standard gasoline. We've got scene lights. I've got my Hurst extrication tools in there. Got a BLS kit here, basic life support, EMT type of stuff. Tools in there for all types of things. Scene lights. This is oxygen tank. For medical, Rancher 450, 340, that's a 340 Husky in there, Wildland saw with the Wildland saw kit, and then my red bag, bunker gear. We got there, 1.5 inch, 2.5 inch, reverse lay, forward lay in there. And over here on the side, we got coming out the back, we got a discharge, two inch and a halves with a gated Y on there for Wildland. We use quarter turn, so we can interface with DNR. It's all quarter turn fittings, those are nice. Got to plug in there. Here, I've got two Traeger SCBAs. That's the air packs that we use to go into fire. And a spare bottle. And then we've got my hose bundles there. Packs, hose packs. And here, we got, this is my Wildland section here. I kind of set this up the way I liked it. Seems to make sense here. So I've got a whole bunch of 1.5 inch and 1 inch Wildland. These are my progressive lay packs that have 200 feet with nozzles and gated Ys, so I can grab two of those, throw them on my shoulder, and extend, pretty close to 500 feet. Gated Y, different fittings. And here I've got some fire tools. I've got a grass rake. Here's the handle for it. I've got a fire, FSS fire shovel, of course. In the last compartment, more Wildland. This is the Wildland side. So in here, I picked all these tools that I like. So I've got an FSS Pulaski. I've got a military grade, Wildland grade combi tool with a long handle. This is basically just an entrenching tool like soldiers have used for, I don't know if they still use them. Got a grub hoe there, a digger, bolt cutters. What have we got there? Got irons in there and chain into some extra water. So that kind of complements the Wildland stuff there. Yeah, pretty cool, huh? I'm excited to get to use it. This thing will go anywhere, don't you think? With those big old monster tires. Probably wondering what this thing is. This is a exhaust sucker. So when we come in, we put this on the exhaust right here. And as soon as you start it, a vacuum turns on. There's a sensor right here. It senses the exhaust gases. And it keeps the station from filling up with exhaust smoke. Here's the pump panel. This is old school pump panel. And I'm very fortunate. When I used to be a paid firefighter in Colorado, and I went to academy to learn how to be an engineer, how to run all the pump, these pumps and everything. And this is what we learned on, except they were way bigger than this. But the old school with the relief valve, this is all analog. No computers like we have on our newer engines. So everything has got to be done all manually. And I like it because I think it's more reliable. The other ones are really nice, especially for volunteer departments, because they've got a computer and it figures everything out for you. You really don't have to think, which is nice when you're on a fire scene, and especially for volunteers, because we don't often get a lot of practice. And when things are complicated like this, it can cause problems. I'm very fortunate that I got to spend so much time on old pump panels like this that I feel very confident and comfortable with them. But I like it. It suits me. The only thing I don't like is the electric valves for the tank to pump. You know, those, if it's electric, it'll give you problems. I like old school knob, you know, levers. They're going to work. And even if they don't work, you can usually crawl under there and fix it, or at least turn it on. The reason why they put these on here, though, is because I've got to be able to activate them inside. So I understand why they did that. That's fine. I'll just keep an eye on it, make sure that it's, I guess having another switch inside might be a bit of a backup, but. Pretty cool little pump panel. Here's the top. Lots of storage, lots of compartments. I've got all these compartments all open up here. These access the hose beds. That was where the gigantic foam cell was. It's just a huge well. Because this was a crash truck, you know, they use lots of foam. And I have foam capability on this as well, and through all the ports. And so there's the fill, and you can see that big turret up there, a monitor, scene lights. 12 volts, so they're not real bright, but they're better than none. This is kind of interesting. They replaced the headlights with the worn red flashers and put the headlights down in the bumper. Probably, I know why, because it's just too tall. This thing is so tall. This right here, this, the bumper, the top of the bumper is that above my waist. So that's why they did that. This is kind of funny. You might get a kick out of this. You want to talk about analog? You've heard of the KISS, Keep It Simple, Stupid? Well, that's Keep It Simple, Stupid right there. This has air brakes. And so we keep, the fire station, we keep an air line hooked up to the engine so we can leave quickly. We don't have to wait for the onboard compressor to pump up and release the brakes. But what happens is you get excited and you drive away with the airline and you tear the airline out of the wall. So this right here is what we just devised. Remove airline from back of truck before driving. So you can't get in it, you can't step up without there. So it always reminds you. So it's a fail-safe, really great analog system there.